You're probably all familiar with the little fruit fly that you find flying around your kitchen in August or whatever when you got some overripe bananas or other type of fruit. These little guys come into overripe fruit, lay their eggs on it, and develop. Unfortunately, we now have its nasty cousin, I guess would be a good way of putting it, the spotted wing Drosophila, which we call SWD for short. It arrived in the U.S. from Asia in 2008 and made its way across the entire United States to Maine in 2011 when we found it. The problem with it is, unlike its cousin, which goes to that ripe fruit, this one has what we call a serrated ovipositor, the structure that it uses to lay eggs with, and it saws into the side of ripening small fruits especially and lays its eggs. Extremely sensitive are the soft fruits like raspberries, strawberries, and those type of things. So we're out now trying to work with growers and consumers to get the word out about this new pest and to trap for it as much as possible. To trap for SWD, a spotted wing Drosophila, all we have been doing is using a red plastic cup with you put some holes in it, put a bait in it, and if you prefer, like I do, I put a yellow sticky card in it, but you don't have to do that. But this is, we found that according to some research, that red seems to be an attractive color to the SWD, so that's why we decided to use the red cup. We're also looking at other colors, clear and some other colors. There are two reasons for the holes in the side of the cup. One is after we've put the bait in, the bait actually has volatile chemicals that come off in it, and those chemicals can actually be detected by the SWD fly, and as it comes in, of course, it zeroes in on that particular chemical, finds the trap, lands on the trap, and then eventually will climb in one of these holes as it gets stronger and stronger towards the aroma that it's looking for. Once it gets in the trap, it gets down either into the bait and drowns, or in the case of like we do with the yellow sticky card in there, it gets stuck on the sticky card, then we just take this back. In my case, I take it back to lab, look at it under a microscope, but you can also look at it with just a hand lens and determine what the species are. As we've seen, we have it right nestled in the tomato plants. We try to do the same thing with raspberries, blueberries, and even really down low when we're trapping in strawberries. But another critical part to the actual trapping of this critter is putting a trap on the edge of the woods near the crop that you're trying to protect. We have found that oftentimes that's the first trap that actually catches a spotted wing Drosophila. Part of the reason is there's lots of wild berries going on. This trap directly behind us, about probably 25 feet, there's a wild patch of raspberries and blackberries back there. So this is an ideal location that may have sustained a population over the winter. So an off-site, out of the field, along the edge of the woods trap is critical when you're trapping.